Welcome to Tuesday with Tim, a chance to stay in touch, be in community together, and hear familiar music. I found myself thinking a lot about reconciliation in song. I closed the last Tuesday with Tim with a meditation from Carl Jenkins, The Peacemakers. And the middle section has been standing out in my mind, especially as we live through this time of pandemic, racial awakening, and trying to bridge our human connections via a digital world. All this is stirring up so much within us as we try to determine, where do we go from here? And what does it mean to be a peacemaker in these times? And so from that meditation, peace is a reconciling of opposites. Peace is rooted in love. It lies in the heart, waiting to be nourished, blossomed, and flourish until it embraces the world. Now, the opening chorus you heard tonight is a setting of the Sanctus. The Sanctus is a hymn of praise based on the vision of worship found in Isaiah chapter 6. It symbolizes the coming together of people on earth with the company of heaven who ran the race before us. All of creation crying out in praise and yet seeking to be sent back into the world renewed to serve greater purpose. The performance you heard comes from the Wayne Oratory Society's first performance at the National Cathedral in 2017. That performance opportunity developed out of a chance visit from a colleague and friend in 2015. 2015 was my first year directing the Wayne Oratory Society, and we began our season with the Brahms Requiem. Randy Edwards, founder of YouthQ, was in Washington, D.C. for a Labor Day festival and came to Wayne to see the church and the music program. He attended our first rehearsal, and I remember him saying afterwards, "Your people love to sing." Now, I was thinking about the technical issues, the Philadelphia vowel twinges, the unceasing fortissimos, the musical issues, but his experience at rehearsal centered on the spirit of our community. Fast forward several weeks to the first week of November, and Randy returned again to Wayne to attend both of our concerts. Randy and I met Monday after the concerts for lunch, and again, he reiterated, the choir just radiates love and joy and their passion to sing. And this conversation led to the expansion of the Wayne Oratory Society beyond the Wayne community, as well as into the digital world of YouTube. Part of the challenge of music performance, and especially choral music, is mastering enough of the technical demands that the human spirit shines through. To put it another way, in the words of Herbert Spencer, an English philosopher, singing is the idealization of the natural language of feelings. Alberto Grau is a Venezuelan conductor and composer, and he wrote a book for conductors and talked about the connectedness of the human spirit through music. He writes, "Music is a language that connects us through communication and expression. Through music, a choir can share values of very diverse communities and eras. Even if we do not understand the meaning of the words, the melodies, the harmonies, and rhythms reveal to us the perfume of old events, of deep traditions, of times and places long past. Music revives them and makes them ours again. There is no old music. It belongs to the present time. Though science and technology have changed and keep changing very rapidly, human beings are nonetheless human beings. This is why when we read a Greek drama, a picaresque novel, or romantic poetry, when we see the portrait of a Renaissance Madonna, or a wheat field of intense colors and a flock of ravens above it, when we hear a choir of Tibetan monks reciting the sacred syllable in ascending glissandos, or the rendition of the Gloria of the solemn Baroque Mass, or a soprano's love aria, we're touched with an intensity that is equal or even greater than when those works of art were created." That paragraph takes me back to the summer after my senior year of high school. I was active in my church's youth program, and each summer we took a week-long mission trip. Now, the trips cycled each year between an urban experience, rural, international, or special needs. And that summer, we were at the international stage of the cycle. We were working with an organization called Bridges to Community, and our destination was Salangapa, Nicaragua. We flew to the capital city of Managua and took a bus northward into the mountains to this small town. Now, we were arriving in the mid-90s after decades of revolution and fighting, and as a result of the fighting, many families were left with widowed mothers. And their dilemma was generating income while caring for their children. So our primary work while there was to build a cinder block community center that would provide childcare while mothers made handcraft goods that could be sold to generate income. Now, we stayed in the church in town. It was a cinder block building with bars on the windows. And when we first arrived in our bus and gathered in our living quarters, the children of the town came running and were hanging off the bars of the windows, chattering at us. We certainly knew that we were guests disrupting this quiet mountain town. And I had two roles beyond the building projects. One was to provide distraction of the children while our group showered in open stalls with buckets. So each afternoon, as the workday was ending, I rounded up the kids to go play baseball. Now, I did not speak Spanish at all, but we managed to make teams and share in the spirit of play. I learned to recognize the kids because they wore the same clothes every day. The boy in the Raiders t-shirt, watch out, he was the ringleader of mischief. I'd also brought my classical guitar with me. Since we were staying in the church over a Sunday, we had to accommodate their worship needs. And so we cleared our gear and prepared for worship together. Some of the townspeople noticed my guitar, and I was asked to play as part of the service with two of their guitarists. Again, not speaking Spanish, they taught me by rote the chord changes, the strum patterns, and I picked up the melodies, though I didn't know the words. The church was cramped with adults, the children were hanging off the bars on the windows, and as one body of many voices and stories, we engaged in a profoundly heartfelt worship service, truly bridging communities in song and human spirit. Carlos Vega, the Argentinian musicologist, writes, "We can create, interpret, or simply hear music without knowing anything about musical notation. Therefore, musical notation is not music." Or another way, sincere expression, spiritual openness, and surrender to the music are at least as important as technical perfection in performance. I want to share with you a piece of music that was recorded for tonight's program. While it's called Simple Song, simple is relative to accumulated technical skill. But what I want you to hear in this art song are the ways it calls us to action, to sing, to praise, to trust, to rise, to reflect God's love into this world.
Sing God a simple song out aloud, make it up as you go along, out aloud. Sing like you like to sing. God loves all simple things, for God is the simplest of all. For God is the simplest of thank you. bless him, to bless the Lord. I will sing his praises while I live. Blessed is the man who loves the Lord. Blessed is the man who praises him. Laudate, and walks in his ways. I will lift up my eyes to the hills from whence comes my help. My shade is the shade upon my right hand, and the sun will not smite me by day, nor the moon at night. Blessed is the man who loves the Lord. Lauda, lauda, laude, and walks in his way.
Thank you, Mike and Tristan, for sharing that song with us tonight. Jonathan Edwards, the 18th century preacher known for spearheading the Great Awakening, wrote, "The best, most beautiful, and most perfect way that we have of expressing sweet concord of mind to each other is by music. When I would form in my mind an idea of society in the highest degree happy, I think of them as expressing their love, their joy, and their inward concord and spiritual beauty of their souls by sweetly singing to each other." Fast forward a few decades, and we encounter Quaker preacher, artist Edward Hicks, born in Bucks County in 1780. Hicks is famous for his painting titled The Peaceable Kingdom, juxtaposing the scene of Isaiah 11 with William Penn signing a treaty of friendship with the indigenous Lenape tribe. Hicks painted it 62 times during his career. One of those copies is at the Philadelphia Art Museum. And in it, he depicts predators and prey lying down together in harmony, and a little rosy-cheeked child, the Christ child, leading them. The text from Isaiah that inspired this painting reads, "The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion and the fattened calf together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the cobra, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain. For the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea." This painting inspired Randall Thompson, you know him from his famous Alleluia, to explore the book of Isaiah, where he hand-selected verses. Similar to Brahms designing his own Requiem, this was Thompson's first self-designed song cycle of sacred texts. The narrative structure of the Peaceable Kingdom was woven together for specific didactic effect, the conflict between good and evil, and its final resolution. From the beginning, Thompson equates the righteous with singing for joy and the wicked with howling for vexation. And the closing of the work focuses on singing and gladness of heart as manifestations of the Spirit. In a musical composition, the end is implicit in the beginning. A natural progression towards the final note begins with the first one. This is true of all living things. And so as you hear this next anthem, the first note in the basses is the same as their last one. The incredible part is the journey in between.
Have ye not known? Have ye not heard? Hath it not been told you from the beginning? Have ye not understood from the foundation?
As we close tonight, my prayer for you is that you hear the song on your heart. May your spirit shine out in your words and actions as we continue to discover our peaceable kingdom together. Thank you for joining me tonight. And I leave you where we started the evening. Peace is a reconciling of opposites. Peace is rooted in love. It lies in the heart, waiting to be nourished. Blossom and flourish until it embraces the world. God bless you.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you
and give you peace.
And give you peace.
And give you peace.
And give you peace. The Lord make his face to shine upon you
and be gracious.
And be gracious. The Lord be gracious, gracious.